please welcome the multi-talented star of Little House on the Prairie, Michael Landon.
The Western is an art form indelibly stamped, made in America. From our nation's beginning, it has been captured in the paintings and sculpture of men of such genius as Russell and Remington, in the stories of Bret Hart and Zane Grey. Good against evil, one man alone facing his destiny on a deserted street for that dramatic showdown. Now, the Western film moved our art form forward with such movies as Stagecoach and High Noon. And naturally, when television rode into the entertainment scene, the Westerns topped the popularity polls.
Are you still there, boys?
With his faithful Indian companion, Tonto, the daring and resourceful masked rider of the plains, led the fight for law and order in the early West. The Lone Ranger rides again.
It was the kids who were responsible for the first overwhelming success of Westerns on TV.
The Roy Rogers Show, starring Roy Rogers, King of the Cowboys, Trigger, his golden palomino, and Dale Evans, Queen of the West.
Westerns were quick to grow up, and along came a whole new breed of TV cowboys, like Hugh O'Brien as Wyatt Earp.
Now, it'll be an even fight if you come into town. We'll lose men, and so will you. All Dave wants is me. I'm the one your crowd is sore at, not Wichita. So let you and me settle it, Mr. Clements. Get off your horse. Not here. When I drop you, I don't want 50 bullets in my gizzard.
And Jim Arness as Marshal Dillon.
Howdy, mister.
What do you men want?
We took 2 days to trail you. Looks like we caught you instead of you catching us, Marshal. Hold it.
I told you you ain't alone. Get over here. I'll be doggone. What are you doing here, McCall?
It's Kemp. Kemp, isn't it?
Arizona. 3 years ago, and I ain't been back since. But how come an old outlaw like you is running with a U.S. Marshal?
What?
Can't be taking you in. You're still carrying your gun.
I didn't see any reason to tell you about it.
Get your horse, McCall, if you want to go with us.
Well, now, wait a minute here, Kemp. What do you got in mind?
Well, there's three of us. Four of us now. We'll leave them to rot.
All right, let's get this over with. Were you after them, Matt?
I don't even know who they are.
Don't even know us. What a liar. Get over on this side, McCall. You can saddle up later.
Listen, Kemp, you know me. I was never very strong about lawmen. You know that.
I reckon.
Well, it just seems like three against one. I don't go for that. More or less four.
What are you saying, McCall?
Well, I was just thinking maybe it might be a little more interesting to say three against two.
First, you can stay out of this.
Well, I know I can, but I was always a little contrary about it.
The TV Western was copied and recopied until there were almost as many horses as viewers. At one point, there were actually 39 popular Western series on the air in a given week. And each Western hero toted his own creative character touch in the form of his own special weapon.
Loaded pistols and loaded dives. Take my warning or pay the price. 'Cause it ain't healthy to try it twice. Loaded pistols and loaded dives. Now this kept going on for quite a while. They made an awful dent in Larry's pile. He reached down in his boot and got a 10. And then he shot the 10 and lost again. He stopped the game and said, I'm countrified, but still I know you took me for a ride. I also know the rules are plainly writ, but I'm about to change them up a bit. Loaded pistols and loaded dice, take my warning or pay the price. Da 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 da. Loaded pistols and loaded dice.
The good guys of the Fabulous 50s not only had a unique assortment of weapons, they knew how to use them when the bad guys showed up.
Where did all those Indians come from?
Who shot him in the back?
Now there's no use in any more bloodshed.
Final moments of any Western, there's always the customary ride off into the sunset. Well, in our Bonanza pilot, we tried a sort of musical comedy exit. And for the first and thankfully last time, sang the lyrics to the Bonanza theme.
I've got a flair for women everywhere. Bonanza!
Bonanza! Aye, aye, aye!
And when I call on Hitty Gal at all, she's gonna welcome
me. Too much noise. Can't sleep.
I'm not afraid of any pretty maid. Bonanza! Bonanza! When I give a kiss to any pretty miss, she'll learn a lot from me. 1-4-4-4-4-1, this we guarantee. We got a right to pick a little fight. Bonanza, bonanza. If anyone fights any one of us, he's got a fight with me.
In 1953, when we were all wondering about the price of that doggy in the window, learning how to play Scrabble and craning our necks to watch all the new widescreen movies, situation comedies were big television treats. The Life of Riley, first on radio and then on TV, was a forerunner of the great family sitcoms. And the first star who played Riley was a much younger, much thinner, Jackie Gleason.
I'm sinking fast. You know, so hot. Flippish old God.
Oh, no, that wasn't the doctor. That was the butcher. I took that message. The beef heart.
I took the doctor.
Riley, you dope? Oh, this beats all.
Oh, I thought you sure are mixed up. Mixed up? He's nuts.
Oh, Daddy, how can you make such a mistake?
You mean that I'm going to live? What a revolting development this is.
You know, you couldn't ask for a better guide to the wacky, wonderful world of sitcom than our next hostess. She's wondrously wacky herself, which is why we all adore her. Lucille Ball.